Hello everyone, today we are going to read about the topic Poka Yoga, which is also known as mistake proofing. Now before going to this topic, let me make you understand actually the concept of Poka Yoga and how this actually concept is actually we are seeing in our day-to-day life. Actually, what is Poka Yoga? Poka Yoga is a lean manufacturing tool which refers to mistake proofing or error proofing, which is a process. Okay, error proofing process. That means here we are actually trying to reduce the number of mistakes. We cannot say reducing the number of mistakes. The number of mistakes should be equal to zero. So it's a lean manufacturing tool which refers to mistake proofing or error proofing a process. So actually it was originally coined or by a person, Shigo Shingo, in the year 1960 and implemented at the Toyota company in Japan. Okay, and this is a part of TPS, which is known as the Toyota production system. Poka Yoga is also present in our everyday life. As I was saying in the starting, it is present in our everyday life, as we will discuss now the different day-to-day examples which we come across in our day-to-day life. For example, the car safety features. Now most of you know that the car is equipped with many error proofing or mistake proofing features like beep or light up. Now that means if the doors are open while the engine is running, or if someone is in the passenger seat and the seat belt is not fastened, so a beep actually comes out. Yeah, if the door is not properly closed, the car beeps out. So this is actually you can say the implementation of this particular Poka Yoga. So these are the examples of warning functions which alerts the drivers who are the potential users. Okay, so these are the that an error is taking place actually in that particular system. So safety technology has advanced significantly in the recent years. Many cars nowadays, they are equipped with sensors that alerts the drivers that they are going in the wrong lane, and the sensors warns the drivers if they are very too close to the another car or another object. So these are some kind of safety features which you basically find in the cars, or nowadays in most of the heavy automobiles also. The second example is treadmill. Most of you have the habit of doing morning exercises on treadmills. Now here on the treadmill also you have one safety clip. So when you're pulling that safety clip, suddenly the treadmill stops. That means this actually safety feature has been given assuming that if a particular user is falling, okay, and in order to prevent injury, suddenly if you pull the clip, the treadmill stops. So this is one kind of safety. Similarly, you have come across different things which are the part of your day-to-day life. One more thing is washing machines, then other household appliances where you find the sensors, then you have the lift elevators which I'm talking about, then garage doors, automated garage doors, then spell check functions like in Microsoft Word. We have, if we write the spelling of a particular word in a wrong way, then it actually says that there is a spelling mistake. So we have like power outlets and USB plugs also. Then we have one more most important thing which you almost all of you might have seen, the wheelchair wheels. wheelchair wheels are designed in such a way that if the chair is not in motion, they lock the wheels lock by itself. So this ensures the occupant doesn't slip when moving in out of the wheelchair. So this ends up with a dangerous situation with a runaway chair. So this is somewhat the introductory part which I am actually sharing with you about this poka yoke, which is the other name is mistake proofing. So after this lecture, you will be able to know what is poka yoke in the manufacturing field, why poka yoke is important, then principles of mistake proofing and poka yoke, prevention-based poka yoke versus detection-based poka yoke. So these are the four important contents which you will be knowing. The concept of all this will be clear to you after completing the lecture. You will be able to know these four things. Now coming to the first part, what is poka yoke in manufacturing? Now basically, as I already told you, that humans are not 100% perfect. Sometimes they make mistakes, and when they make mistakes, these mistakes causes defective products. And here you see, I am actually talking with reference to a manufacturing company. Okay, if an operator on a machine, he's doing some mistakes, so due to that mistakes which the operator is doing, there is a production of defective products. So this poka yoke, which is also known as mistake proofing, so it is a technique for avoiding these simple human errors who are actually working near the machine or the manufacturing plant. So this poka yoke concept, actually we are implementing it. So these are mechanisms to eliminate errors by effectively making it impossible. That means the operators who are working nearer to the machine, clear? They should have a particular concept clear in their mind that they should not make any mistakes when they are doing a particular process on a particular machinery. Okay, so this is a kind of a mechanism where you are actually using it to eliminate different kinds of errors which are possible to happen while a particular process is going on. Let me give in one more example. Like in most of the of in almost all the offices, you find these filing cabinets. When at a time you pull all the filing cabinets, all the filing cabinets fall down. So there is a particular safety precaution that is given to this filing cabinet, that if you open one drawer, so one particular cabinet, the other cabinet locks all that means the cabinet which you're opening, it locks the other cabinets, so reducing the chance of falling all the cabinets falling at one time, which is also called as a cabinet tipping. Okay, and we have like one more example. Like in elevators, you might have seen there are sensors actually near the door. If the person's some part of the body is remaining in between the elevator doors, the door will never close. Clear? So why poka yoke? So you see, manufacturing defective products, it is a very costly affair. So if you manufacture defective products, and defective products are manufactured, it is by virtue of the person doing maybe a small mistake, or it can be a big mistake. So mistake is a mistake, so whether it is small or big. If it is a small mistake also, ultimately the final product will be a defective product. So ultimately, if the defective product is reaching the market, so the customers will return the product to the company if they're finding it defective. So we should be very careful, because Manufacturing involves some cost. So if you are manufacturing defective products, you are wasting your time, you are wasting your resources, you are wasting your money, everything, all the resources you are wasting it. And some products actually which are critical, like there are some products which are related to safety applications, like in motor vehicles, aeroplanes, then rigging of oil or oil explorations. In those cases, there is no question of 0.0001% of error also, because ultimately what will happen, a failure in these kinds of areas, ultimately there is a loss of life. So there is no question of where the safety is of utmost importance, there is no question of any error has to be taken place. So let's now see the relationship between the defects and the human errors, like means in a manufacturing company or maybe in our day-to-day life also we do these kinds of defects and human errors. Okay, so here actually you can see the human errors which I was talking about. There are actually 10 different kinds of human errors, and here 10 causes of defects. You can see the different defects are like, if you are not properly following the procedures, then processing errors, then errors in part setup. That means if your setup is only totally faulty in nature, then there are some missing parts, wrong parts you are putting, then you are processing a totally different wrong workpiece, then totally misoperation, adjustment error, improper equipment setup, improper tools and tools. So these are some set of causes of defects. So different types of human errors are errors which we do it intentionally, sometimes errors caused due to misunderstanding, sometimes errors are due to we forget something, and we have different kinds of errors, like we have surprise, non-supervision. If nobody is supervising you, you do human beings do errors. Then some people do errors due to this slowness behavior that of doing the work. Then inadvertent error, then willful error. Some people willingly do these kinds of errors, and some do errors or mistakes due to inexperience. So we have two kinds of symbols. You see, one is totally filled up with black color, and the other is you can say white. Okay, so this is strongly connected and this is connected. So this is one of a particular example. It's not that for every industry or any process this particular thing is going to happen. Suppose how actually this you are going to understand. So first one, you see, not following procedures. So if a person is not following procedures, it may be due to intentional, or he forgot, or inadvertent error. So do you understand? So these three errors are strongly connected, and the other errors are, you can say, they are connected with each other. So here one thing is missing, that is surprise. So if you are not following the procedure, means that is not a surprise. Is this clear? So let us talk about one thing, misoperation. One more I can talk here. Similarly, you can just understand the other part. In misoperation, you can see, misoperation means what? Actually, to do a particular process, you are operating in a wrong way. Okay, if you are not following the process in a correct way, so it is not intentional, or you cannot say it is a misunderstanding. So if you are doing, if you know the operation, the operational steps are given to you, still you are doing misoperation, then it is a surprise. So that is a strongly connected. So the connected are you are doing misoperation because nobody is supervising you, non-supervision, then inadvertent error, and the other son is you forgot it. You forgot it to follow the operations that has to be followed. So this is all about a normal example. The relationship between defects and human errors actually has shown you here. The next one is the benefits of Bokka Yoga. Now, human errors are actually, you can say, the error can be small. Then if you have to actually repeat off means you have to actually close that mistake until it becomes a bigger issue. We see some kind of people where we understand that we are making mistakes and we don't actually rectify it. So that becomes again a bigger problem to them. Okay. So what I am trying to actually say here is when you think that when the error or the mistake is small in shape or small in size, you can say in terms of size, okay, so you should not make it, or you should not wait until it becomes a bigger issue. Okay, so mainly this Bokka Yoga, it reduces or it eliminates these human errors. Yeah, these human errors, they cause defects. Clear? So what are the 9 benefits of Bokka Yoga which you can see? The first benefit is decreased setup time with associated reduction in production time and improved productivity. So if you are implementing this Bokka Yoga, so ultimately the setup time is decreased. Setup time means to arrange the machine before the process starts. That is called setup. Clear? And with associated reduction in production time and improved productivity. That means you can reduce the production time and you can also improve the productivity. Improving productivity means you have to get the maximum output with minimum input. That means minimum input in the sense you have to utilize the resources in the most effective way. Then if you use it without any wastage, then ultimately the output will be more, so you can improve the productivity. So then next one is, second one is elimination of setup errors, then improved quality, then one more benefit is increased safety. If we implement these Bokka Yoga, the safety becomes the first and most important part, as we have studied in the starting of the class. Then comes here, lower the cost of quality control. The cost of the quality control will become less. Then if you implement Bokka Yoga, skill requirements, lower skill requirements then are required. Then the flexibility in the production is increasing. Then one more thing is inspection time reduces. Clear? See, inspection time reduces means, you see, ultimately if you target how to reduce the mistakes, so ultimately the inspection time will reduce. Okay, so that is what he is saying. Reducing inspection time means if you are producing the product without any errors or mistakes, so ultimately the person who is inspecting, he will take less amount of time to inspect your product or quality of the product. Then the attitude of the operator can be improved. And last one is the customer who is actually receiving your product with no errors or no mistakes, the customer will be satisfied and the customer becomes loyal to you. Okay, so these are the very important benefits of Bokka Yoga. Now, what are the principles of mistake proofing, which is very very important, and that is Bokka Yoga. So this total Bokka Yoga is actually based on 6 principles. So in order of preference, let us study. The first principle is elimination. Don't do it anymore. Elimination means we have to eliminate those kind of processes or those kinds of things which you think that in future there may be a possibility of error. I hope you understood. That means you should take out those elements which you think that in future due to these elements error may occur in future. So how to eliminate those kinds of those kinds of things? So that you can do it by redesigning the product or process. So that the task or part is no longer necessary. Second principle is prevention. Make sure that it can never be done wrong. That means you have to design and engineer the product or the process so that it is impossible to make a mistake at all. So prevention is better than cure, as you know. So what I'm trying to say is you have to design or you have to create the process in such a way that the person who is actually manufacturing the product should not find any difficulty in manufacturing it, and he should not do not even a single mistake while doing that process to complete the final product. So that kind of this particular prevention technique you have to use it. So that kind of design and what you can say, the engineer or the process, you have to create it, so that no one is going to do mistakes. Okay, first is elimination, second is prevention, then replacement, use something better. So if you think that there is another process which is much more reliable than the process, than the existing process which you are using maybe from last 1 month or last 1 year, so it is better to replace it to improve the consistency. See, you should not replace it unnecessarily. If you think that it will be helpful to improve the quality of the product, or it is improving for decreasing the production time, then you think about this replacement. Okay, then felicitation. Now this makes the tasks easier to perform. That means you have to bring out those kinds of techniques which makes work easier to perform. So the particular person who is actually working on the mission, he should not be, the process should not be in such a complex way that he is not understanding anything. So if the process is itself complex, if the design itself is complex, ultimately the operator will do mistakes. Okay, so these out of six, these four: elimination, prevention, replacement and facilitation, these actually four are used to avoid the occurrence of mistakes. As you can see here, these four are used to avoid the occurrence of mistakes. So these four: elimination, prevention, replacement and facilitation, they are used actually to avoid the occurrence of mistakes. Means the mistake should not occur, that it has to be done. Then fifth one is detection. So you should detect actually what is going wrong. So if you find that while operating a particular machine or when you are manufacturing a particular product, if you find that at any particular point of time or at particular juncture, if you find that something is going wrong, better you stop it. So you have to identify the error beforehandedly and don't try to process it. That means you know that you are doing wrong, and if you still want to continue that particular process, okay, you know, and you have identified the error. So the best way is you identify the error and you stop it. So if you continue, ultimately what will happen is you are going to get a very defective product. Okay, then so you try to, if you find an error, you try to correct yourself. So ultimately, at the same moment, if you detect a problem, you try to correct it and proceed further. The last one is mitigation. Don't let the situation get too bad. That means it is to seek to minimize the effect of error. That means the errors should actually, you should not do those kinds of errors where the situation becomes worse enough and you cannot come back. Clear? So now these two, the first four, elimination, prevention, replacement, facilitation, these are actually principles which are used to avoid the occurrence of errors, and detection and mitigation, they are used to minimize the effect of mistakes once they occur. So these are the principles of Poka Yoga, which is very, very important. And coming to the last portion, that is prevention based Poka Yoga versus detection based Poka Yoga. Now you see, what is prevention detection? Now this is also very important. Ideally, why actually Poka Yoga ensures, that means the process is designed so that the mistakes can be created, prevented. So what he is trying to say is, this particular implementation of Poka Yoga has come into existence such that you can prevent the mistakes before they occur. So if you try to prevent those mistakes, that means ultimately you are preventing the defects from occurring in the first place. Yeah. So that means beforehandedly you should try to find out what are the mistakes, and ultimately there is no question of any defective products to be manufactured. But there is a possibility, if you miss this particular juncture, that means preventive based Poka Yoga has crossed. That means you are not able to find out the mistakes and you have not prevented it. Then ultimately it goes to the next stage. When it goes to the next stage, so you should detect it. Okay, you should perform a detective function, and after detecting the error, you should correct it and eliminate the defects in the process as early as possible. I hope you understood. First one is prevention. First, you, while a particular process, when you are designing it, you are trying to avoid the mistakes that can be prevented in future, to avoid the defects has not to be produced in a particular product. But if you are missing that step, it is better go to the next. You try to detect that particular error, okay, then eliminate the defects in the process as early as possible. Now a prevention based Poka Yoga system acts before a defect occurs. Now what, as already I told you, a prevention based Poka Yoga system acts before a defect occurs. The Poka Yoga mechanism sense an abnormality, what is about to happen, and then signal the occurrence. So what I actually am trying to say is, now you see, if anything bad is going to happen, you are going to get some kind of signal. So let me take a very clear example. Suppose you are actually boiling the milk in the kitchen, okay, and you have forgotten it. So ultimately what happens is, if the milk boils, and actually when it comes, it goes above the boiling point, a smell comes. That actually I am talking about, that is an abnormality. So before anything bad is going to happen, an abnormality is going to take place. It's a kind of signal, okay. So that is called, you can prevent it. If you can sense that abnormality, that means you can also prevent. The next is, if you are not able to prevent it, best is a detection based, where a mistake has been made, you are trying to find out what is that mistake, and you are trying to correct it, and you are trying to eliminate that defects as early as possible. Okay, so In some of the situations, it is not possible. That means economically also it is not feasible to prevent defects. So ultimately, in those cases, what happens is, so we always try to remember whatever the cost that is involved in implementing this Pokayok mechanism, it exceeds the cost of prevention. For these situations, defects are detected early in the process, preventing them from flowing into downstream process. So the commonly implemented Pokayok devices in manufacturing: prevention based Pokayok, detection based Pokayok. So here actually you can see the prevention based Pokayok, where we use 100% prevention devices, and in detection based Pokayok we ensure 100% detection of the mistake. That means you can see different examples like pins, counter locators, proximity or photoelectric sensors, then limit switches, micro switches, warning lights or buzzers, pressure sensors, vision systems. So these are all 100% prevention device, prevention based Pokayok. Okay, so these are all Pokayok implementation devices in manufacturing system. And next is detection based Pokayok. We ensure 100% detection of the mistake, like you are trying to detect here, like examples are electronic sensors, color code, graphics, contact devices, fixtures limits, and we have LEDs, pressure sensors, vision systems, etc. So this is all about the prevention based Pokayok and detection based Pokayok. So basically what I am actually trying to say here is, if you try to implement this Pokayok, the number of errors can be decreased in any field, okay, whether it is manufacturing or field, or whether it is service field, in whatever field it is. Okay, thank you very much. If you like this video, kindly comment it, like and share. Thank you.